Hey YouTube! In today's video, I want to talk about automating Baserow with N8n. So, Baserow in itself is a very powerful database application, and you can do a lot with the web front end, and it's very easy to use, and you can even build powerful applications. But from my point of view, Baserow gets even more powerful when you combine it with an automation solution like N8n, Make, or Zapier. And in this video, I want to demonstrate the basic setup, how you can connect your Baserow instance or your Baserow database to N8n, and how you can start automating processes. So, let's get into it. As you can see on the Baserow homepage, there's an extra page talking about automating Baserow, and the solutions that are presented here are Zapier, N8n, and Make. And I will go into detail for N8n now, because that's first and foremost the most powerful automation platform out of these three. And N8n also allows you to do much more advanced automations than the other two platforms. Integrating Baserow and N8n is quite easy, so the only thing you really need to do is you need to go to your N8n instance and then go over to your credentials and say you want to add a new credential for Baserow here, continue. And in my case, I am running my own instance, so I need to change the host name to the URL where my Baserow instance is running. If you are using Baserow Cloud, you can just leave it as it is. And for the username, I just take the username I use to log into my Baserow instance and just my regular password and save it. And now I am actually good to go. So I will just quickly create a new workflow and search for the Baserow node here. And for now, I will just get many rows here. So you can see here, up here, you have the credentials that's already pre-selected for the Baserow account we have just created. The resource we want to access is the row. And here we have different options just for now. And to see if the connection is running, we will just go for get many. As you can see, the connection between Baserow and N8n has already fetched all the databases I have on this instance. And the one I want to access here is the campaigns database. And when I have selected the database, I can just select the table within it. And here I can just declare how many records I want to fetch. So when I test this step now, you can see that I got all my entries here. And when I scroll to the right, you can see I have the name of the campaign here. I got the number of sales. I got the total revenue. I got the average order revenue. And when I go to the other side, you can see the same here. I got the name, the sales, the total revenue, and the average order revenue. What this allows us to do is to manipulate data within Baserow externally. So you can use this to integrate your Baserow database into any kind of system that has a RESTful API. And just for demo purposes, we will just play a little bit around with this. Over here, we had this node here where we got our data from the campaign table. When we have the connection between Baserow and N8n, we can change data in Baserow very easily. So just let me update this workflow a little bit, because the campaigns table is not really useful in this case. So I will just fetch the contacts here and limit this to one, so we get the first contact. And now I will just pin the data. That means that this node will always output this exact data set, so we don't need to fetch it each time when we play around with it. And what I can do now is I can just add another Baserow node, and let's say, for example, we create a new row. And here we select our campaigns table again, and we were on contacts. And down here, we can define the fields to send over to Baserow. What you can do is you can just map the fields to each other. In this case, the fields are exactly the same, so I can just assign first name to first name and so on and so forth. But this could also be an external data source. So this could be data that is coming from a web shop or from a CRM platform or whatever. And with this, you can just easily map the data here. And just for demo purposes, I can also just put fixed values here. So I just do demo, and for the last name, I will also do demo. And then I can just hit test step, and you can see this has succeeded now. And when I go back to my Baserow instance into contacts and I scroll down to the bottom, you can see that this row has been created. And this will allow you to very easily populate your database from any kind of external data source. When you have a look into the available nodes here you have on N8n and you select just action and an app, there are a lot of ready-made connections you can just use to fetch data from any kind of service on the internet. And even if the service is not supported, as long as it has an API, you can use it in N8n and just build your own stuff out of it. And of course, the automation and integration of Baserow and N8n also works the other way around. I can just create a webhook in N8n, and just for demo purposes, I will do that without authentication. You can also build authentication so you can make sure that no one else can use your webhooks. So I will just put this to none, and I get a test URL up here. I can just click and then it's copied to my clipboard, and we want to receive data from Baserow. So I put this to a post request and say listen for test event. And on the Baserow side, I just go for the three dots up here and say webhooks and just say create a new webhook. And here I put my URL and the post request like we did in N8n. And here I can decide what events should be sent over to the webhook. So for example, I can just say, okay, each time a row is created, this workflow in N8n should be triggered, and the workflow will execute whatever action I want. That's basically how it works. Just for now, I will do send everything and just trigger a test webhook. And you can see here that we get a 200 OK. That means that the request was successfully sent over to N8n. And when we have a look at the N8n side, you can see that we received the data from Baserow. What you can see here in the body is we got the table ID, the database ID, and here we got the items that have been sent over, and that's working for now. And just to test this on a real event, I will just say, okay, each time a row is created, and hit save. And here I will listen for a test event again. And here I just say duplicate row. And when we look over here under the items, you can see that my demo row has been created here and my workflow got notified about it. And there are different things you can do with an automation like this. For example, you could use N8n to perform actions on events that happen in Baserow. But what you can also do is you can combine both solutions in a clever way. So for example, you can enter data into Baserow and you can trigger a workflow that will, for example, go into your CRM and fetch some data about a customer or whatever and enrich the data set you have just created in Baserow. So the possibilities are kind of endless here. Just to round this up for now, I will quickly show you how we can secure the webhook. So there is an authentication in between, so you are sure no one else can access your webhook here. So what we can do here is we just double click on the webhook here. And for the authentication, we take header here. And here we can just create a new account in our authentication database. So I will just name this one from campaigns in Baserow. And here I just put a key value pair here. So the name of the header entry I want to have is pairs, or we can just name it token. And for the value, I will just take 12345. And save it here. And when I go to Baserow and let's listen for a test event here, and I trigger a test webhook, you can see that I get the warning that the authorization data is wrong. So what we can do now is we can just use the header part up here, and we take the token, and here we take our password. And now when we try again, you can see that this has been successfully authenticated. And that's basically the way how you can make sure that you got a private and secure connection between Baserow and N8n. Another thing I would like to go into today is manual API calls to Baserow. As you can see, you have this configured node here where you have different operations you can use. So you can get entries, you can post entries, and you can update entries. But sometimes you get into a scenario where you want to do more complicated things and where this predefined node for Baserow reaches its limits. And that's where the API from Baserow comes into play. So when I am at my Baserow instance and I go for the three dots here and go to view API docs, you can see I get a documentation for the Baserow API. And this is available no matter if you are on your own instance or if you are on the cloud version of Baserow. So here I have my campaigns table. And when I scroll down here, I get examples for requests here. As you can see, here we have an authorization that will ask for a database token. So in order to get this working with N8n, we need to go up here to our settings and go to my settings. And here we have database tokens, and we can just create a token and name this one N8n demo. And I can assign the token to a specific workspace and just create the token. And here you can see you can also manage what the token can do. So for example, when you have an external partner who needs to, I don't know, fetch some parts of your data, maybe you are selling products or providing product data over an API, then you can make sure that the third party can only read data sets but cannot change data sets, for example. In order to get the token here, we can just go for the three dots here and just copy it. And then we can get back over to N8n and just for now save our workflow. And now we go back to the credentials parts again. And here we can just select the header authentication. And when we have a look at our Baserow API documentation, you can see here the header needs to be authorization so that we can just copy over. And then the format here is, you have the keyword token, then you have a space, and then you have the token provided by Baserow. So what I will do now is here, I will just copy my token. And down here, I will just enter token manually and the space, and then paste in my token here. And we name this one Baserow demo and save it and go back to our workflow. And what I can do now is I can just get an HTTP request node. And in our nice documentation here for the Baserow API, you can see you have request samples here. And you have different formats you can use. And I can just copy this one here and just import it here and say import. And as you can see, this will automatically populate the fields. And in order for this to work, this needs a trailing slash. And you can see you can send the authorization as part of the request here, but I wouldn't really recommend that, because when you back up your workflows or when you share workflows with other parties and so on and so forth, this will be readable to the other party. The secure way to handle things like this is to use the credentials function we have seen a couple of minutes before. So you can just delete this one here, and we don't want to send the headers here. And here you can just say we have a credential, a generic authentication type here, and we select the header authentication and select Baserow demo. And when I test the step here, you can see I get the response from Baserow here. So I just wanted to show you how you can make a manual API call. And of course, if you want to interact with Baserow, let's say from code or anything else, it's also good to know how to use the database token, because you don't need a ready-made solution like here in N8n to interact with your Baserow database. You can just build your own stuff and use it just with regular HTTP requests. So the last thing I want to talk about is filtering, because that makes API requests on Baserow very useful, especially when you work with other external sources and you need to fetch a specific data set. So what you have here in Baserow, so what we can do here is we can add a filter, and let's say we have email and we say we want all of them to use the domain msn.com, and we can test the step. And here you can see we just get the items where msn.com is. And we can also do the same on the manual request here. So what we can do here is we can say send query parameters. When we go to the contacts table and get the row, you find a hint here that says user field name equals true. That's basically telling in the request that we want to filter by the field name and not by the field ID. Because when you look here at your fields, where do we have it? You always have a field ID. But when we have, so for the manual requests, you have query parameters we can use here. And when I look at the documentation here, I got the same on the list rows, and here it says we have a parameter that says user field name, and this will enable us to search by the field name and not by the field ID. So that's the first one we are using here. So we take user field names and put this one to true, and then we add another parameter, and here we can just say we want a filter. And then we need a double underscore, and then we need our field name we want to filter on. And in this example, this would be email. And then we just need an operator here. And here I just put the msn.com in. And now we test this. And here you can see we get the results where msn.com is in the email field. In your API documentation, you have filters down here. And here you can see the different operators you can use and how they are used. So you have equal, not equal, and you can query for dates and so on and so forth. So that's just a high-level overview how you can interact with Baserow and its API and how you can connect it to tools like N8n. As I said in the start, there are also other ready-made integrations like Zapier and Make and probably others too. I prefer N8n because it's the most flexible and most powerful solution. And as you can see, just with the manual HTTP requests, you can easily integrate Baserow into almost anything. So that's it from me today. And if you have any questions, please let me know down in the comments. Please like and subscribe if this video was helpful for you, and have a nice day. Take care. Bye.